Okay, in this video, you're gonna see us do a blackout or chrome delete, which we do quite frequently for this dealership. This is the first time we've done a blue one, or matte blue. It's quite a cool color, actually. We'll be deleting the chrome on the bumper, on the front grille, and those bits down there around the spotlights, and then also the running boards, badge on the side, wing mirrors, and the rear bumper, as well as the badges on the back. I'll just show you what we do, and I'll just explain the process of how we do this for dealerships, so that you can see these badges on the back. We do everything basically in permanent paint, except the individual letters. We do that with Autoflex, which is a peelable paint. And the reason I do that is so we don't have to remove those badges, because I found in the past when we've done it with permanent paint and we go to stick the badges back on, it just stands off the panel in like a non-factory way. So of course this car is brand spanking new. It's about to be delivered to a customer from the dealership. So we want to try and keep everything as factory standard as possible, including the paint finish. So to do this process, actually we remove most of the panels. So we'll take the front bumper off to get the front grill off and those bits in the front, just so we can get, you know, the paint all around the edges. And then the same with the wing mirrors. I'll actually take this cap off so we can get that bottom bit off. And as you can see down there, the running boards have been removed. And then I'll actually take the plastic tread plates off as well, just so we can get paint under there and make sure that everything's covered properly. Just gonna show you guys how to remove both the wing mirror assembly, well, the wing mirror assembly, which will include the mirror glass on the front, the bit that you look into, the main cap, and then also this chrome bottom section. It's quite simple. You just gotta pay attention to a couple of clips and their location. But other than that, it's pretty simple. Only need two tools, well, three tools, if I can get this one as well. So we've got a plastic lever, basically, a little pick tool, and a T10 Torx. First thing I do, if you come around this side, Nick, is I pull the glass out by sticking this guy behind here. Careful not to break it, but it's always a risk, so you never know. Bang. Okay, and then there's two wires there for the heated mirror. I'll just use the pick tool to grab those spade terminals. Where are they? There. And just pick them off like that. There's one. Another one. There, bang. So that's that off. Set that to the side. I'll just put it on the windscreen for now. And then if you look in here, can you come closer? Let's see these two tabs. That's holding this down. So what I do is I lift one away and then I lift it up just to sit, make sure that that's, there we go, bang, it's one. Oops, it's gone back in. And you just have to be like a little bit clever. This cap goes up, it doesn't come forward, so you just got to be mindful of that. And then once I've done that one, I'll move to this other clip here, and then that will relieve some more pressure. Bang, you can see there, see how easy it lifts up now. And then I go around the front edge here, and you're just basically prying it so that it, you lift it up. Now it is held in there pretty tightly, but don't be scared. In terms of the clips, like the clips tend to hold them in quite tight, but you just need to give it some, you know. And then bang. And none of that's not actually breaking any clips, believe it or not, although it does sound like it. You just gotta persevere, you know. And there's one in the, there's a clip over here on this side that you kind of do have to look at. It's hard to get the camera in here while, but it's in there. You come around, it's in just there behind this section. So yeah, I'll show you what it looks like once I've pulled it off. Bang. So there's that clip I was talking about. There's that tab over there. But yeah, you just have to lift it straight up and then that's it. Then that takes the cover off. And the next thing we want to do to get this off is loosen the two T10 bolts they are on this side. See there, there's these two. Bang, comes out the bottom. So there you have it. One, two, three pieces removed. Okay, I'll have one with no sugar as well, thanks. I'm gonna show you how to take the front grill off. You do unfortunately have to take the whole bumper off to get the grill off because of the way, the amount and the type of clips that they are behind this section here where the grill is attached to the bumper. So the way I do it is pull the whole bumper off, loosen the clips or pry them loose, and then pop the grill off, and then I put the bumper back on because it goes back in place pretty easily. It's just that the clips are quite sharp, so they need to be like levered out so you can get them, and it's not safe to do with it on the car. This is a brand new ute that we're painting this, and this but satin black, so we have to do it in a way that looks like it hasn't been touched. Screws on the top here, screws down the side, screws all the way along the bottom and up the other side. They are all T25 and T30s. There's two behind the number plate as well, so don't forget those. And then yeah, once you have that off, the bumper comes off pretty easily. Here you can see the clips I was talking about earlier on, how they just held in there a bit too tight. You need to release them with a tool so that you don't break them. So just use a tool like that basically, or flathead screwdriver, because all you want to do is just twist it so that you can release the clip. Boom, just like that, all gone. Okay, so I've just finished tearing the car down and stripping the running boards and other bits and pieces. We sand that with either 120 or 180 grit sandpaper, just because chrome is so hard, it's quite tough to key up effectively. So we do that with really aggressive sandpaper, and then after that I use an acid edge primer and then 2K satin black on everything. Okay, so we got the parts in the booth. Nathaniel and I are just going over now, giving it the final Prepsol wipe and then the tack rag wipe and anti-static blowdown with our stat gun. But the first product that we're going to be putting down on the chrome is an acid etch. What that really does is it bonds and binds to the chrome, allowing the subsequent coats, in this case satin black, to stick and adhere properly, allowing us to give a nice, good, professional warranty on the work that we do. Front grill, spotlight covers, wing mirror, lowers, running boards, badges. Did this side badge on the sport bar, look cool. And then also rear bumper and the badges on the back. So that's the video, just showing you guys the process of what we do to do these blackouts in the shop. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Maybe share this video with somebody.